Here we go. It looks like he's been dusting himself in some rather dark soil. Giving him a lovely, much darker sort of coloration than the other two to the right of him. And there's two of them that have been dusting themselves in dark. So Anne is wondering, is an elephant's footprint like a fingerprint? As in, is it unique? Indeed it is. Each individual elephant will have a unique set of wrinkles along their feet, just like the wrinkles along our fingerprints. So yes, they do have a very unique footprint. Now, of course, this area is also quite good for the sausage tree pride, or a portion of the sausage tree pride. We're convinced there, well, we're not convinced, we know there's sort of two sausage tree prides, probably splinters from each other. Who was first and who was the biggest, I'm not sure. I think the ones that live closest to home are probably the splinter from the bigger group that's down here. There's a very distinct female in that group who's got a kinky tail, and they've got two young males who hang about with them as well. But unfortunately for them, you can see not many wildebeest and zebra around, just some elephants. But what I find quite amazing is how the animals adapt to the migration not being here. And you'll see a lot more daytime hunts from the lions now. Well, the topi birthing season is now, so there's quite a lot of baby topi around. So they might be taking advantage of that. But the thing, the lions, especially these lions up against the escarpment, and the Angamas, for example, do a lot of warthog hunting. And of course, warthogs like to be home safe down a hole at night. So hopefully that is going to give us a lot more daytime hunts at this time of the year now that the wildebeest have gone. There are certain people amongst our company who still think the wildebeest are going to come back. I don't think they're going to come back, but hopefully I'm wrong. But since it is Lion Day, let's go to the man who lacks a mane, but at least he has some lions.